have someone at the Roberts campaign, but we start with the challenger independent Greg Orman voted this morning in Olathe. This is video of him doing this. And Amy Hawley is there at the campaign in Overland Park. Where? What's the mood?
Well, we're at the Overland Park Convention Center right now, where it's quiet, as you can see back behind me. But the Orman camp says the big party is going to start about 7 o'clock tonight. In fact, the family has even reserved their own space outside of this ballroom here. They say the party's going to begin with disco balls and a whole lot of music outside. So they're preparing for a win. This is such a big deal. All the eyes of the nation are going to be on this. In fact, there's media outlets from all over the nation. In fact, all the midterms elections that I've ever covered in Kansas, I have never seen this kind of coverage from national news media before. It is a really big deal. This is a race that Senator Pat Roberts should not be fighting for. The win should easily be going to him. He has been in Washington for 47 years. As you can see there, Orman cast his ballot early today. Insiders say, though, Roberts' original campaign team did not take the competition with political newcomer independent Greg Orman seriously enough early on until Orman quickly gained traction. So why is Roberts fighting for his job in this traditionally conservative state? Seems like the incumbent anti-Washington mood extends well beyond Washington, and Orman's breaking the gridlock message that he has said time and time again may actually be working. Some polls now have the two candidates with less than a point within each other. Pretty unbelievable. And that has made this unconventional race really attractive, not only to people here, but across the nation. And yes, a journalist as far away as Japan.
Many Japanese people had at first high expectation for the President Obama, but now that his popularity is getting down and down, so many Japanese people are interested in why about such administration.
All eyes back here at home will be on Johnson County, where we're standing tonight. That is about 21% of the votes in all of Kansas, and that's where most of the moderates live in Kansas. The moderates are most willing to go back and forth, vacillate back and forth between Democrat and Republican parties. They will likely determine who wins tonight. In Overland Park, Amy Hawley, 41 Action News.